I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkness night, you are close like no other.
Father, we bless you so much for what you have done for us today. This day called the 22nd November 2024, you have made it possible for your children to complete this project, which is called Bible House on Kampala Road in the city, Kampala, for the Bible Society, for the proclamation of the gospel. Thank you very, very much for bringing Mama, the First Lady and Imam of this country, to officially open this project. We pray that you bless this building, bless all the work that will be done here, so that people will get to know your word, and your word will be preached, and your word will be lived, to bring transformation of the head, the heart, the hands, the homes, the hospitals, the hotels, the hostels. We pray that, Lord, your word will really change the entire city of Kampala and the entire Uganda and the neighbors. So we pray that you bless us all. Bless the First Lady, bless His Excellency the President, bless all leaders who have given us a very wonderful opportunity and the atmosphere for your word to be preached. We pray that, Lord, you bless this building and bless all the people who will be working in it and bless the Bible Society. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Read your Bible.
Pray every day. Pray every day. Pray every day. Read your Bibles. Pray every day. If you want to grow. If you want to grow. If you want to grow. Read your Bibles.
Thank you. we pray, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this day when we have witnessed the official opening of the new Bible House. We thank you for the First Lady who has honored this occasion with her physical presence, and for all those who have worked hard to see the vision of the Bible House come to fruition. We look back with gratitude to you, Lord, and together we say Ebenezer. And so speak to us through your word, and all to the greater glory and honor of your name. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. The Bible is the most translated book in the world, with about 3,384 languages. It has 1,189 chapters, 31,102 verses, according to the King James Version. There are 7,487 promises made by God to humankind. And you want to ask yourself, how many of those promises do you know? There was a young man who was seen standing on a big Bible. And when asked what he was doing, he said, "I am standing on the promises of God."
Oh, Honorable Matia Kasaija, the Finance Minister. Honorable David Bahati, Minister of State for Trade, Industry and Cooperatives. Honorable Canon Dr. Ruth Nankabirwa Sentamu, Minister of Industries. International guests, all protocol observed, allow me to recognize the international guests that have come and are here present. We have the General Secretary of Bible Society of Tanzania. May I request him to stand for recognition? We have the Treasurer of the Bible Society of Kenya present. May I request him to stand for recognition? And then, Bible Society of Uganda belongs to the umbrella body of United Bible Societies, and they have sent an able representative, Kenneth Amwai, who is representing the General Secretary. You are most welcome to Uganda. To achieve and sustain the mission of Bible Society, the strategic plan of Bible Society advised us to look into mission resilience or self-sustainability. And that's why our predecessors started the construction of the new Bible House, so that the resources from the Bible House can help us to sustain the ministry. Construction of the new Bible House started in September 2021. To be exact, the site was handed over on 21st of September 2021. And the construction went on until 30th of September 2024. That's when the contractors handed over the keys of the new Bible House to our trustees.
I like the words of an unknown author. He says, faith sees the invisible, believes the impossible, and receives the incredible. So that is what faith means. Faith sees the invisible, believes the impossible, and receives the incredible, by an unknown author. I want to appreciate His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, General Kaguta Museveni, and Mama Janet Museveni, for the support towards faith-based organization and parachurch organization. Thank you very, very much. We are always grateful.
Today's Thanksgiving service is an occasion indeed of great significance, not just for the Bible Society of Uganda, but indeed for the nation of Uganda and the people of Uganda. We're reminded by the psalmist, unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that build it. And so may this building that we celebrate today be itself a symbol of the truth that God's kingdom is not tied up in bricks and mortar, but that this building may become the means by which the people of Uganda, communities, families, towns, cities, and the nation itself may build their houses upon the solid rock of God's word, of Jesus Christ, and that God may build these houses through His word. This is indeed the purpose of the mission of Bible Society, working together with the churches. And so it is a pleasure and a privilege for me, on behalf of the United Bible Society's Fellowship, to join you in giving thanks today. This Bible house, and I speak now to Peter and his team and to the board of the Bible Society of Uganda. And we remember at this time also our friend Simon Peter. But to you who are gathered and to those whom you represent, this is your Bible Society. I speak to the representatives of the churches, the Bible Society members, the state dignitaries who are present, to the people of Uganda. This is your Bible house. And may it be something that brings great blessing to your nation. I really encourage you to support in every way the mission of the Bible Society, to support it in prayer, to support it in partnership, to support it in financial giving, also to this building itself, this building that will become a beacon of light for your nation and indeed for Africa. So we celebrate with you as you give thanks to God, who has brought you thus far and put your trust in Him to take you further. May God bless you.
We proposed many times to invite you to come and see the work that we are doing. But this is the day that the Lord chose for you to come and sit here and look at His glory in the new Bible house. And I know that all our wallets now are more happy than ever before, because you are seeing what you are going to contribute to. Some people want to see and then believe. Others believe right away. But sitting here and facing this beautiful building, I'm sure encourages all of us.
We are here also opening the Bible House. When we go back, they will ask, what have you been doing? And maybe somebody will say, well, we went to witness the opening of the newest building on Bat Valley Road, Bombo Road. It is a magnificent building. It is shiny. It costs 26 billion shillings, all of which is true. But I hope some of us will say we were at a great ceremony presided over by the First Lady of Uganda, opening a Bible house from which will emanate a lot of love, a lot of joy, a lot of forgiveness, and a lot of mercy, and from which the people who work and the resources which are raised from there will cause peace to flow in all corners of Kampala, in all corners of Uganda, in all corners of Africa and the world, as the waters cover the sea, because that's what the Word of God says, and that's what we expect will happen from this token of the Bible House. We therefore thank First Lady for coming to preside over this great occasion, and we thank you all for coming to witness this occasion.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Your Grace, the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, the Most Reverend Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, the Minister of State for Industry, Honorable David Bahati, the President of the Bible Society, Honorable Justice Mike Chibita, the Chairman, Board of Trustees, and Board of Governors of the Bible Society, religious leaders gathered here today, members of the Bible Society Uganda, brothers and sisters in the Lord. I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And it gives me such pleasure to join you at the commissioning of the Bible House, a project whose completion we have all eagerly waited for. So I thank you for including me in this celebration. I bring you warm greetings from the President, who would have loved to be here with us today. But having come back late last night, and with several commitments this morning, he was unable to join us. Let me begin, though, by thanking all members of the Bible Society and our well-wishers who made contributions, both small and big, towards this great effort. Congratulations on realizing its completion, and praise the Lord. Let's give a mighty clap for the Lord. He has done it, and so we celebrate him, and we celebrate what he does for the children of men. This beautiful designed structure not only provides a permanent home for the Bible Society Uganda, but as an office complex, it will provide the much needed revenue to fulfill our mission, to provide affordable Holy Scriptures in languages and media that communicate effectively to the people of this land. I will personally never forget when we received the first Accra Majong Bible when I was in Karamoja. Therefore, the fulfillment of this mission is significant, because in this age and time of digitization, the use of various media to translate and distribute the Word of God is critical if we are to rapidly increase and promote readability of God's Word with every category of our citizens and Christians in general. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, the days of people accessing the Word of God purely through the text, resulting in everyone carrying large Bibles everywhere they went, are long gone now. Currently, Bibles are accessed through digital gadgets, online, and various other electronic and innovative means. But I must confess that I still love my hard copy Bible. With all the markings that I have made in it over the years, I trust that many of us seated here today do enjoy reading our hard copy Bibles. It is, however, important that we keep up with the times and take advantage of this great opportunity of communication in real time to do all it takes to promote the work of the Bible Society. We must provide the financial resources required to reach more people with the Word of God in languages that they can comprehend, preferably their mother tongue. With Joshua 1 verse 8, which reads in quotes, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you have good success," unquote. So we have a duty to our families, to this country, to ensure that we allow our people to access the Bible. I therefore challenge the body of Christ to introduce Bible literacy programs, just as the Bible Society in Uganda has done to complement their translation work. Please consider encouraging and equipping members of your congregations that are not literate to take on the challenge of learning how to read and write. With a higher literacy rate, many more Ugandans will experience the Bible in their own language and thus take advantage of the great work that the Bible Society is doing in translating the Bible. As we celebrate the outstanding work of the Bible Society now in the distribution of the Word of God, I urge everyone who has not yet signed up as a life member of this noble society to do so today, if possible. I've been told the total cost of this project is 25.4 billion, and that you have so far paid Uganda shillings 16.1 billion, an outstanding figure of 10.8 billion. It is from this background that I call upon every Christian, as all my colleagues have done before me in this nation, to contribute towards the completion of this work. My special thanks go to the United Bible Society team and all the international guests who contributed to the construction of this building. As a life member of Bible Society of Uganda, I express my sincere appreciation to all those who gave towards this great work, and I pray that God rewards you abundantly, and I'm confident that He will. I now have brought my seed, and the president gave me an equal seed of his own to make 100 million shillings to this noble work, and may God prosper his work right here. I thank you, and God bless you. Let God really bless you. Thank you.
We started in a gloomy way. We are ending on a very good note. What else can we say other than saying together? Can we say together, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Ebenezer.
Ebenezer.
This far you have brought us. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift his face upon you and be gracious to you. Mama, Your Excellency, the President, the family, every part of your home and family, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord lift his face upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace today as you travel back. May the Lord fill your hearts with that joy. Take that joy and that peace into your homes. Go with it and flash it around for your family, your children, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Tutimize na malengo yetu, jumuiya yetu sote tuilinde, tuajibike, tuimarike, umoja wetu ni nguzo yetu, idumu jumuiya yetu.
PO Box 3621 Kampala, Uganda, or call us on 0414-251-165 or send us an email to info@biblesociety-uganda.org.